I'm going to give you a quick run through of Sage Service Operations for Sage 100 Contractor. The overview I'm going to do is to show how work order processing can be streamlined and sped up by being able to send work orders out to field technicians, have field technicians update them from their mobile device, and then the invoicing process get finished back up in the office. So let's go ahead and get started. So what I'm going to do here is bring up Sage Service Operations, SSO as we like to call it. You'll notice right here I'm looking at a dispatch board for today. I could be looking at the week, I could be looking at 2 weeks, or I could be looking at the month. Over here on the left-hand side of the screen, I have work orders that are in process with different types of status. I can filter and display different things, ones that happen to be unassigned or different service locations, that sort of thing. It's really easy to create a new work order. All you have to do is click over here and select a plus button, new work order. I'm going to put in some information about the location. Let's say it's for our customer called Hotel Inc. They have a couple locations. One happens to be in Iowa City. University of Iowa. The other one is Clark Street in St. Louis, Cardinals. So let's go ahead and put it in Iowa City for the project there. And the customer gives us a PO. And then I could go ahead and assign this to somebody or leave it blank. I'm going to assign it to Brett, and I'm going to say that we have a leaking fixture and funny smell. Let's go ahead and I'm going to update that spell check real quick. Click generate work order. And what you're going to see here is that a work order has been created. It's work order 319. If I go back to the scheduler, you're going to see we have work order 319. I'm going to go ahead and put that out here. We're going to do it here at day's end. So really easy to create a work order, really easy to assign it to staff. If we have multiple crews, we can filter and show things differently there. And let's bring up a mobile phone. And I'm going to go ahead, I happen to be using an iPhone. I'm going to go ahead and bring up my, we call it assignments. So these are all the things I've been working for the week. Normally, this would be filled out and it would show me the time that I'd entered for all of my work orders day by day throughout the week. I'm going to scroll down here to Thursday, and you can see I have three work orders here to complete. Let's say I want to take a look at this Hotel Inc., what's going on with this particular customer. So I just tap on it with my thumb, and it's going to call up that we've done 18 work orders for Hotel Inc., 7 jobs. We have one piece of equipment we routinely service. There's 2 service locations. We have a service contract. We're tracking some refrigerants out there. For those of you that are in the HVAC business, that's an item that can be turned on. And if it's not applicable, it can be turned off. And we have a bunch of attachments. So let's go ahead and pull up that work order. And I'm just going to click here. And I'm going to bring up work order 319. So again, just a couple clicks with my thumb. So these are all the different things that I can do as a field technician. The first one, I can look at an overview of the work order, leaking fixture and a funny smell. Okay, that doesn't really give me much to work with there. You can notice we have these different buttons here that we can take actions on this work order. So first of all, I'm going to look at is assignment. So for those of you that like to do clock in, clock out, start, stop, you can do those types of things. So if I can say I'm starting the work order now, it's going to update the status to open. And if we go back to the dispatch screen, you'll see that the dispatch screen has been opened with this green, means it's in progress now. Again, that's optional whether you do that or not. I'm back here to the field worker. As far as recording time, I can either record time by doing start, stop. That would be where I would say that the assignment is complete, and I could record that time that has occurred so far. Since I did that and it's only a minute, it's really not going to accumulate much time. The other way that you can record time is with this button right here where it says hours. So I'm going to tap my thumb and I can record hours for myself, and maybe I have a helper. So Ryan is helping me today, so I'm also going to have myself and Ryan. We were out there for 4 hours. We're going to bill the customer for 4 hours, and maybe we want to put a few notes out there. Great customer. So I'm just going to click save. So that would record time for myself and Ryan very, very quickly. Let's move on to the next item I want to touch on here. And you'll see where it says inventory parts and miscellaneous items. So for those of you that use inventory, really easy. I can click add part, and maybe we use some wire. So I don't have to remember part numbers or anything like that. I can just type in part of the item that I'm after there. And maybe I have some of the 16 gauge wire and we used 120 feet of it. We could have stocking locations of warehouse, various locations, or even the truck. I'm just going to say it's coming out of our main warehouse. So we've recorded some time, we've recorded some material, and let's say that I created a bracket. So I'm going to say, let's say this is special bracket. I made it out of some leftover material out of my truck. So it's one item. I'm going to say the unit price is zero. And I could say it's material. And actually, you know what? We're going to say it's a $1,200 item. So we've recorded some material, we record some labor. And down here at the bottom of the screen, you can see where it says reports and attachments. Well, let's say I want to take a picture. And generally, I would take a picture before I get started. I didn't in this case, but I'm just going to say repair photo, notice area of work. And I'm going to click choose file and I'm going to take a picture. And in this case, I'm going to take a picture of this nice Sage baseball and my coffee mug. And I'm just going to click add. That's going to save it to my work order. And we'll try that one more time. There we go. I hit the wrong button. Operator error. You'll see it's attached, and there's this button right here called Sketch. What does that do? Well, there's a little sketch tool built into Sage Service Operations, really handy. It's kind of like MS Paint, so it's not a CAD program or anything. But what it lets me do is it lets me stick an image up there, and then I can mark it up. And maybe I just want to put a little diagram here. So let's say you had a leak and you want to take a picture, that type of thing. Where did you get this baseball? So say I'm done with that. Maybe I want to email this back to somebody at the office. We could do that. So I'm going ahead, let's just save it. And I'm going to select reports. So you have the ability to have a leave behind report. And I'm going to go ahead and attach that photo. It's kind of small, so I'm going to turn it sideways. The idea behind this is a document you can leave with the customer. We had a funny smell. Brett was out there, did some work. We had some wire, we fabbed a bracket, had some labor. Is the job complete? Yes. I'm not collecting payment because they're going to invoice that back at the office. And now we can have a place for our customer to sign. And then we can say that we accept the work. And you know what? We're going to go ahead and email that sketch and a copy of that service report to the customer. Meanwhile, notification can go back to the office to say that this work order is complete. And again, I've done this all this from my phone. I can go back to my list of all of my assignments, and I can move on to the next thing. So let's go ahead and move back to the office now. So I'm going to go ahead and call up my Sage 100 contractor, and I'm going to open up the work orders. And let's go to that work order. So leaking fixture, funny smell. If you look over here at the file attachments, you can see that we have the repair photos. Remember, we snapped a picture of that. So it'll take a second for to open up on my desktop here. We can bring up the sketch. So there's that sketch that I made. And then a copy of the service report with all those details. So it's faster than email, automatically back to the office. And then for the staff that's going ahead and finishing out the work order and actually going to invoice it, all of the details that we entered out there in the field are right here. And remember that wire, we said 120. We didn't have any pricing for that wire. Whatever kind of rate tables you have back at the office, those would pre-fill here. And then somebody in the office could go ahead and save this, fill it out, email it out to the customer. So that completes a quick overview of Sage Service Operations for Sage 100 Contractor. If you have additional questions about this or any other videos we do, please contact Bangert Inc. Thank you very much.